everybody's looking for the edge. No matter what their level of competition, athletes are continuously looking for ways to improve performance. Hi, my name is Dr. Annie Hanna, and I'm a vision specialist teaming up with Sporttime JMTA to bring sports vision services to the players.
I am also a JMTA parent. One of the things that I noticed and really loved about the Sporttime JMTA program was that they are interested in the whole player. And so they're interested in the fitness of the player, they're interested in the nutrition of the player, they're interested in the psychology of the player. And bringing on sports vision services is just another example of that.
With 80% of input in sports being visual, it's imperative we pay attention to the development of excellent vision skills in our athletes. It's important to understand that vision and sight are not the same thing. We're very used to hearing 20/20 or 20/15 talked about as our visual capacity, when actually that is just a measurement of sight. And what sight is measuring is your ability to see a very small object that's stationary under conditions of perfect contrast. In sports, that very rarely happens. Things are moving, changing directions, the ball is moving, the player is moving, all while we need to pay attention to what's going on in the court or the field. So when we're talking about vision, we're talking about this collective visual experience of taking in input, processing that, and deciding what to do with that information. So while sight is important and ocular health is very important, we want to make sure the eyes are healthy. We also want to look at contrast sensitivity. We want to look at eye teaming, how well the eyes are working together. That helps with depth perception, which of course is very important in sports. We want to look at eye movements, the fluidity of them, or how well the player can move from target to target. We also want to look at peripheral awareness and peripheral vision, which is the bread and butter of the athlete. Layering on with that, we need to look at eye-hand, eye-foot, and body coordination, as well as balance and visual decision-making. Vision starts in the eye, but the vast majority of the process occurs in the brain, ultimately resulting in action. This process is so complex that it utilizes over 65% of the brain's pathways. Our goal is to strengthen this eye-brain-body connection through assessment, correction, protection, and enhancement. The goal of vision enhancement is to develop an athlete's ability to process the maximum amount of visual information taken in at a glance as rapidly and accurately as possible, all under conditions of physical and mental stress. The beauty of training visual skills for the athlete is that the same 20 or so visual skills that are important on the court or on the field are also really important in information acquisition, ultimately strengthening how that player is going to perform in the classroom.
Finally, we definitely do not want any one of these kids to be limited by a faulty visual system. There has been extensive research done on the visual systems of athletes, and the overwhelming majority of them say the same thing, and that is that the better the athlete, the better the visual system. So that leads us to believe that the visual system is a barrier to entry for any elite athletic performance. My goal as a practitioner for your children is to make sure that their visual system does not stand in the way of their ultimate goals, whether they be on the court, in the classroom, or both.